A Twilight Zone, 1959, The Passerby. Travelling through another dimension, dimension not only sight and sound, but of mind, a journey into a wondrous land. The boundaries are that of imagination. Their next stop, The Twilight Zone. This road is the afterwards of the Civil War. Began at Fort Sumner, South Carolina, ended at a place called Appomattox. Littered with residue, broken battles, and shattered dreams. Madam, do you mind if I have myself some of your water, madam? Please, thank you. Beautiful voices, aren't they? Wasn't it? Beautiful once, wasn't it? The tree and me, madam. Once it was very beautiful. War claims a lot of victims, men, animals, and God's own beauty. Madam, would you mind if I sat here for a spell? Rested a bit? Not at all, thank you. Oh, you mind if I strum a few chords on my old gut box here? Not at all. My husband used to play the guitar. Oh, now. Oh, did he now? He's, now, where is he, madam? He's killed, Yellow Tavern, with General Stuart, I'm sorry, brand new grey, a gold brand, and 1,000 flags, trumpets and drums, nothing but trumpets and drums. Beat the Yanks in a month, that's what they said. Beat the Yanks in a month, how wrong they were. And we stood by our summer dresses and cheered them on, threw flowers, felt so grand. Not many tears, just a few. Because we were so sure they'd all be coming back. Just as they left, how wrong we were. Not feeling well, madam. I'm all right. It's a fever, but I'm on the mend now. I left me a little weak, that's all, a little weak. Till they come morning and night, night to morning, they'll walk down that road, the young ones, the old ones. How worn they look, how tired. Are there hundreds of them or thousands of them? Wouldn't you think? What do you think, that there are so many? My Judd, might be amongst them. Sergeant, madam, ma'am? Would you do me a favour, if I can, ma'am? Could you play that your guitar real loud? I mean, real loud, down me out. Loud, madam? I'm sick to death of hearing my own crying, the sound of footsteps on the road. Please play it loud, as I can hear music. Oh, madam, please, sergeant, as you wish, my lady. Back is the colour of my true love's hair, her lips are something wondrous fair, purest eyes, in just a moment you enter a strange preference that knows neither self or south. Place we call the Twilight Zone. Charlie Hum, Charlie Constable, Charlie, Savina. We thought you had been killed. That's what everybody said. They said you'd been shot in the head at Gettysburg. Oh, I'm so glad you've come back, Charlie. Oh, I'm so glad you were all right. Couldn't you stop a minute, Charlie? Almost there, Lorena. Your wife will be so glad to see you. So very, very glad. Don't need all this weight. Leave it here, old Charlie. Leave it here. I've got to keep moving. Got to keep moving. Goodbye. Oh, Charlie, will you give Susan my best? Tell her when you get settled to please come over. Though I expect she wants to keep you to herself. I know if Judd come home to me, I hold him close, so close, never let him leave again. I'm sure, Lavina, that was Charlie Constable. He said he'd been killed by Gettysburg, shot for the head. Thank God they made a mistake. Thank God that's what's wrong, madam. Why is there blood on his cap? There's blood on Charlie's cap. You finished already? Yes, madam. I've got a feeling for wood. You know, whether it's chopping or carving or wearing it. Yeah, like my goat box here. See this? Oh, made that myself. Of course, it's not as good as the one I got at home. I got more time then, you understand. Remember my daddy used to say to me, gonna wind up nothing but a good old nothing terrible. A daddy of mine, I see him now. The way he used to look at me, his face all squinted up like a persimmon. He stuck his finger right in my head, he say, Abby, you've got nothing inside you. It's but soft much as so bad at sad about us. Ain't you going to grow up and become a man? Oh, he's a proud one the day I marched off to war. He's just as proud as the old rooster. You know, there was his son marching off to war to become a man. I came back half of my man, me. But I did come back. You know that song of yours? What is it? Was it? Black is the colour, my true love's fair hair. That's the one. My lips are something wondrous fair. Through his eyes and dated his hands. I love Jug, my husband. He used to sing that song. Did he now? I wish he could have met him. He was a very gentle man, a very nice man. Can remember nights? Why, he would sit here on the very porch, he'd play and sing. You and the crickets would keep quiet. I bet you did. They did too. The bullfrogs down the pond. Just as they stopped their noises so they could hear the music. And then the Yankees came like blue locusts. They had to eat away at the trees and land and everything on it. Owe them for much. For our house, our land, our trees, for everything, including my husband's life. Owe them for much, madam. Why don't you go away from here? The place is no good for you. Why, this place is all I have, sergeant. Yes, madam. What do you suppose happened to the Yankee who killed my husband? Suppose he's marching home, his own kin now. Suppose he's laughing and singing and telling his neighbour about the rebels he killed. All the bullets and all the heads he shot them through. No, madam. Don't reckon anything like that at all. I let the kind of poison out set on your mind. You're dying from it, poor madam. I've got a gun inside. A gun, huh? It's an old shotgun. Keeping of it. About how someday, some moment, a Yankee's going to come up here. I'm going to take out that gun. I'm going to aim it at him. But first I'm going to tell him that he considered his last shot of the Civil War a bullet exchange for the one my husband took. No, madam. Don't want to hear no more talk about butchery and bloodshed. There's hundreds and thousands of men and boys who were killed and maimed. And then Mr. Lincoln murdered. No, I don't want to hear no more. But who's that? Hello, yes. I wonder if you could tell me if there's any water around here. Yeah, there is some water here in the well. I'm sure the lady in the house wouldn't mind if you had some, Lieutenant. Travelling far? Just up the road. I've been on it a long time. You too? Yes, a long time. I still seems to me that I know you. We met somewhere, huh? That's possible. I don't know what it is, but I'm trying to remember. Go on, what is it you remember? I got it. It was lying on the side of the road. A shell just exploded, tore half my foot. Came by with patrol Yankees. He stopped there on the road, side of the road. Bent over, took care of me. Stopped the bleeding. Don't you remember that, Lieutenant? Yes, I remember that. Sure, of course you do. I'd like you to meet the lady in the house. Madam, this is the madam. You better pay heed to the sergeant's gratitude, because it's the last gift you ever get. I promise you. Let me have that gun, madam. This is your pleasure. Madam, you're on duty. A little both, perhaps. Then you'd best get on with it. Madam Lieutenant, you tried to save my life. You thanked him. Now, if you step aside so I can thank him for a few other services, I couldn't miss you. Doesn't make any difference whether you did or whether you didn't. Wait a minute. Now it's coming now. I got it. I remember you got that. They got you that day, Lieutenant. You tended me, and a shell exploded in the trees of my head. This hot steel went spraying all over the place. I remember you standing up and clawing at your eyes and screaming, I'm blind. I remember thinking they killed you. I remember thinking you were dead. Does it make any difference now, either? The water and the well certainly, Lieutenant. I wish you the best, madam. I do wish you the best. And you, sir? Thank you. This too shall pass. Wait and see, Miss Goodwin. Good morning, Sergeant. Morning, madam. You come down for a minute? You're leaving? Yes, madam, I'm leaving. I come to say goodbye and say to thank you. I've got to get back on the road, to wherever the road leads. Well, I'll tell you where the road leads. Leads past 50 miles of places like this, burned out houses. Yes, madam. But you see, Miss Goodwin, I was up to most of the night thinking about a lot of things. I'm thinking about the bearing lieutenant, your young friend, Trader Constable, the blood in his hat, and then something during the night. Sometimes during the night they stopped coming and it got quiet on the road. Got real quiet. And in the quiet, just before dawn, it came to me what I did. Don't know just how to explain it to you, madam, but it's got to do with the road. Those men moving down. They were Union soldiers, man, too, madam. Some of them helping my boys, some of my boys helping them. But all of them, all them moving down the road together, just as if, what? Don't know, madam. There's something down the end of the road. Got to find out what it is. So I'll take care, take my leave, madam. I wish you well. Sergeant, sergeant, I'll be alone. Please don't go away. Stay here. No, madam. Nothing here that could ever belong to me. What do you think? Find at the end of that road a future? A new self-acts, a new curfew, born at the ashes? Please, black is the colour of my true love's hair. Judd, how fares my wife? Oh, Judd, please. Oh, I've been ill, Judd. I've been very ill. You'll better be all right. Now you come home. It was home, Lavina. It isn't any longer. We can build it. We can paint. We can plough the fields. We can buy the seed. What's the matter, Judd? Sergeant Captain, you know. I think I do. I'm not sure, but I think I do, Mace Godwin. I've no doubt. No doubt at all. I've been seeing you again in time. The end of that road. Judd, what happened? Your life in Lavina. Well, it's kind of like a song. You play it right to the end. When the notes are finished, they die out. There's only silence. Then, that's when you move on. Judd, are we dead? Yes, like all the men, those men on the road. Mine came at the Yellow Tavern with bullet. Yours came here with fever. No, Judd, no, I'm alive. Don't want to leave here because if I do, it means I'll give up everything. But there's nothing to give up. Judd, don't leave me. Not leaving you, my darling. I'll wait for you. I'll meet you at the end of the road, oh, Judd. I'll wait for you. Judd, come back to me. Judd, come back, Judd. You'll stay behind. My dear, maybe it's not too wise. It's so wise. Afraid, of course you are. I am too. Of all the wonders I've yet to have heard, it seems to me strange that men should fear seeing that death, this very end, will come when it will come. That's from Shakespeare, Julius Caesar. You see, my dear, I'm dead too. I guess you might say I'm last casualty of Civil War, no. I'm last man on this road, no. Judd, in an accident on dirt road during the month of April, the year 1865. As really pointed out, his road that won't be found on a map. Is one of many lead out of the Twilight Zone.